Hello guys, and welcome to How to Tech. If you are a beginner to Midjourney, this video is going to be very important for you, so stick around till the end. Now let's get started. As a beginner, you are generally advised to come to these particular rooms, right? So what we do when we create our first images is we come to a particular room. Let's say I'm in room newbies 150. Now you will find yourself overwhelmed with a lot of images. If you are new to Midjourney, you go ahead and give something known as an imagine prompt. I'll directly come to the basics. You give slash, you say imagine, and then you can give your prompt. So the prompt that I'm going to give is this: dust in the wind, decaying from the unstoppable flow of time. So this is just a concept that I'm giving to Midjourney. Now Midjourney is supposed to create the image. As soon as I hit on enter, it will automatically, my image is going to vanish. Look, it has started the processing, and I have given entered this particular command at 7:17 p.m. IST. And how will I recognize this is going to be my image? Because of this small yellow bar that you are able to look at the left hand side. Now after some time, now see, it has started creating, but you will see other people also typing in their images at the same time. And after some time, you will face a lot of challenge in sticking with your particular image. But I do not want this to happen each and every time. And I wish someone would tell me when I was starting out with Midjourney. But hey, guess what? There is a solution to this problem. Okay, I really like this image. So I'll go ahead and try to upscale this third one. So I'll go ahead and upscale this. So I'll click on U3. In the meanwhile, while it is getting upscaled, I'll show you what you can do so that any image that you go ahead and type in, the prompt of any image that you type in, you are never going to get lost amongst other images. And for this, you need to create your own server. Don't worry, it's a very simple step. It will take only seconds. You see this small plus sign over here? It says add a server. Go ahead, click this. It will ask you to create your own server. So over here, you will say create my own for me and my friends. Over here, you will give some name. So instead of this, I'll say my own little server. Right? This is the name that I'm going to give for the server. If you want, you can upload an image as well. And I'll click on create. That's it. Look, now it has created this MOLS, that is my own little server. Nice name, right? Okay, now one last thing that you need to do, and this is very important. If you go over here and you say slash imagine, you see the imagine prompt is not going to be valid. You cannot give an imagine prompt over here. Why? Because there is something known as the Midjourney bot. If you go to other servers that I have created, if you go to the DaVinci server, which is my own server, you see there is something called the Midjourney bot. If you go to the main Midjourney, and if you go to, let's say, any of these newbies rooms, you see the Midjourney bot is always by default going to be a part of any room or any server. So you have to include this Midjourney bot to your new server that you have created. The easiest way to do that is go to Midjourney, right? Click on any of the newbies room, and over here on the right hand side, the Midjourney bot that you are seeing, just click this Midjourney bot, okay, and click on this option called add to server. Once you click on add to server, it will ask you to which server this particular Midjourney bot needs to be added. Now I already have the DaVinci server and test which I have created. Right now I need to add this to my own little server, right? So I'll add this to my own little server. Click on continue. Okay, this is fine. Just click on authorize and click on I am human. Okay, now finally I am authorized. Congratulations guys, now the new Midjourney bot has been added to your new server. If you go to the new server, you will see your Midjourney bot over here, and you can go ahead and say slash imagine, and over here you're free to give your any prompt that you want. So now if I give this particular prompt, the same prompt that I was giving earlier, you see this is going to be my personal space, and I will not be having any other images created from any other users in this personal space of mine. So go ahead and give as many imagine prompts as possible without ever getting disturbed from other users. One more bonus tips: how can you see all your images together? Right? For that, you just have to come to your browser and type in midjourney.com. Once you type in midjourney.com, click on go to gallery. Once you go to gallery, you'll be having all your creations under home, right? You just scroll in. DaVinci is my profile, so if I just scroll down, you can see all my images together in a single place, right? So that's how you can see all the images at a single place. And this is going to be your server where you can go ahead and experiment, type in the imagine prompt and create as many possibilities as you can. So with that, guys, I'd like to request you, if you're liking my videos, please do not forget to subscribe, which is going to keep me motivated, and give some likes, and go out, if you have any comments, give them out as well. I'll be more than happy to answer. So happy AI and keep creating. Bye bye.